Evening, I would like to call the April 26, 2016 Zoning Board of Appeals meeting order. The first order of business is usually to approve the minutes of the prior meeting, which is March 22, 2016. I believe from some review that board members have made, I think we're going to work on these a little bit more. So we're going to table the minutes from the last meeting until the next meeting. There's no old business, so we'll move right into the one item of new business on the agenda, which is to hear the request of Timothy and Catherine Martin for a variance to build a 35-by-28 garage on the left rear corner of their non-conforming lot at 13 Thrasher Road, map E32, lot 6-10. This lot is outside of a shoreline overlay district. The request is to build a garage 10 feet from the rear property line instead of 15 feet required in the zoning ordinance. Mr. and Mrs. Martin?
Good evening, and thanks for coming out on this nice spring day. Wife and I have lived in Cape Year for over 17 years, in our three-bedroom ranch, raised ranch, slowly working on it. We would like to include a garage for our personal vehicles, as well as the abundance of sports and other equipment that we all seem to be accumulating over the years. My main point of the variance is trying to get, because of the way my house is situated on the lot, with the ledge to the left side of the house, the sewer line that was eventually attached after the sewer septic systems were abolished runs out to that side of the house, along that left side of the house and out to the street. Part of the sewer line runs under the driveway that exists now out back there, and I was trying to mitigate any more exposure of that sewer line to possible freezing. I have not had any issues to date. The other issue is cost, which is the ledge that's on that left side of the house. If I could move it down that 5 feet, that would allow my cost to drop considerably. Basically, in a nutshell, if you have questions, I'd be more than happy to answer.
So the current driveway for the home is on the left side there, or it's on the right side of the house?
It's on the right side. It runs down the... Yeah.
So does it actually go around the whole back?
Yeah.
And so there is a garage on the property currently in that spot, or no? Is there a garage currently on the property?
There is a one-car garage that's underneath the house. As a raised ranch, a third of the basement's a family room. A third of it's the actual basement with the furnace and so forth in it. And then there's the one-car garage, which really doesn't fit today's vehicles that well. All of our other stuff that wasn't in a shed that would be out in the property was in the garage around the vehicle that we could get in there at the time.
So I guess what I'm asking now is the drive, it's indicated on the plan you gave us.
Yep.
Paved drive. Does this already exist going all the way around the back?
Goes all the way around the back, correct, yes.
Oh, the entrance is in the back of the house. Okay.
Yeah.
Understood.
Yeah, there's no access other than the front door on the building.
Okay. Have you looked at the possibility of relocating the existing propane and gas lines and perhaps dealing with the ledge? And if so, what the estimated cost might be?
The propane and electrical lines that go out on that side, I mean, really, it's not so much relocating them, it wouldn't, it would, the new garage, they'd be located right beside the outside wall of the foundation. That's where they'd be going. The only issue, really, for me, is cost of blasting and/or now people don't want to blast, so they hammer out the rock, which is time and material labor in doing so. It's more of trying to get away from my sewer line, which is right, I don't know if it shows up on that plan very well. I did take some pictures on another set of that sewer line, right, it is on that, it's not shown up very well, but I did take some pictures on one of the local town maps, which showing garages in that, but I thought I had a picture of that sewer line, but I guess I...
The sewer line runs out the back of our house, and it wraps around the left, and because of where he mapped it, we had someone come and map it out, and where it lands, if we're afraid to get too close with the edge of the garage, because we don't really want to disturb the sewer if we can help it, the more you work around them, the more you, if we blast and stuff, we are taking the chances of doing damage to our sewer line, and we'd rather not do that cost in if we have to.
And I guess my question really is, if you were to build this so that it fit within the existing setback requirements established by the town,
yep,
what would you really be looking at for a cost differential, given that you probably would have to move some lines, probably would have to do some hammering or blasting or something like that?
What is proposed now would be minimal. What if I did it within the zoning ordinance? Nobody gave me a figure. They gave me a rough idea. Could be as much as, you know, 2,000, 3,000. They wouldn't really know until they get in there and start the work. Nothing's been unearthed, but given the fact I've been in the building trades for a while, they didn't build on that side of the property line for a reason. That was because of the ledge. It was easier to build to the right side of that lot. They did blast to put the sewer line in to get it out to the street. So there is a ledge there for that. But it all depends on how much hammering they would have to do. You know, my guess is anywhere between $2,000 to $3,000 in addition to what's going to happen if I am allowed to encroach that 5 feet.
And a follow-up question, it looks as though from the material you've included with your application that you're considering a three-bay garage, is that correct?
Yeah.
And what impact would, if you were to downsize that to say a two-bay garage, would that then fit within the existing setbacks?
I'm sure it probably would fit it within the setbacks. It's a question of then where am I putting all the rest of the stuff that I've been having in a shed. I had an existing shed out in that side yard. I've always had sheds since I moved there, just because of there is no space in the house for anything. It's just one of those things with the raised ranch. What it is what it is. And done.
Thank you.
But with the addition of the out, if it were a two-car garage, let's say, then you would have space freed up in the one-car garage that's currently in the home? You wouldn't have to park cars in the internal garage anymore.
If we put a...
Yeah, if you're building additional two bays, okay, or two vehicles, let's say.
Yeah.
Then you've got storage space, theoretically, in the one bay that's in the basement of the house.
Right. Yeah. I was intending on having some workspace out in the garage. It was my intent to have the vehicles out there in the workspace and then have space, more space in the house for everything that we accumulate in today's society, that sports equipment and everything else, you know, the lawn mowers, and I do have a snow blower and such. It just never seems to find enough space for everything.
Mr. Martin, I was looking at this, and I wonder if you could tell me if I'm correctly reading it. I take it that the proposed garage will actually replace a shed, and that shed's going to be gone?
Correct.
And the shed, according to this, looks like it currently encroaches on the side setback. Is that right?
It was, yeah. I don't know that that was exactly when he had the measurements. It's possible. At the time that that shed was placed, the neighbor that was in the house living to my left told me we had no property lines, had no property pins. I had nothing to go by. He told me where he thought the line was, and I positioned the shed accordingly to what he thought.
So if I'm reading this correctly, then the new proposed garage will eliminate that side setback encroachment.
Correct. Yeah, and if you read the back, it's only going to be 4 feet, 4 inches in the back corner and 5 just in the front corner. Just the way the back lot line, it's not a square lot. So my left side property is actually shorter than my right side property sidelines, if you understand what I'm saying.
I do. Thank you.
Yep.
Could I follow up on some of these questions? I want to make sure I'm reading this and understanding it. The current gas line, electric line, go under the proposed garage anyway, correct?
I'm sorry, say that again?
If I'm reading this correctly, the existing propane gas line and electric line will go under the new garage anyway.
Correct? No, I would intend just to move those lines to the left side of the garage, and it would be then out to the back side of that garage on the front left corner, if you will.
Okay, so your I guess problem is to move the garage 5 more feet is the difficulty?
The difficulty is exposing my sewer line, which would be right on the corner of the garage if I did it within...
I'm sorry, would be what?
The corner of the garage would be right on my sewer line if I did it within the setbacks. And that's my big concern. The other concern, obviously, is cost. The cost of hammering the ledge to get the foundation in.
Okay, and I guess the point of the... You've given us several photos. The one that does not show the other garages, I guess the point of that is to show us what?
Well, the idea is to show in the neighborhood and the surrounding areas, and I had a map there that showed where these garages were in relationship to what I had put on there, that what is becoming, there are garages, two-car garages with either breezeways or more storage space beside them, or three-car or even a four-car garage. And part of my presentation was that today's family with two or three kids, you're coming up with a lot of outside activities, sports, boating, kayaking, and the three-bay is our two vehicles, lawn mowers, snow blowers, sports equipment, and so forth.
Okay, yeah, we can come back to that. I wasn't clear about my question. My question is about the other photograph, the one that does not show the other garages. It says if building was in setbacks, you've got the drain pipe showing, and I guess the sewer pipe.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I thought I... Yeah, I don't have that copy.
I think that's actually shown where the sewer line runs.
Yeah, I hit a picture and circled a picture.
Yeah.
That's actually where the sewer line runs up through.
It's showing, this is just a drain line coming off my roof. And there's a green
line across the lawn area, and that's the actual sewer line. The white line at the end of the pipe is the corner of the garage, if I get it within the 5-foot set, or the 15-foot back property line.
So, I see. So that's, that's the distance you'd have to move the sewer line?
I'm not moving my sewer line.
No, I understand. If you were within the code, that's the distance you'd have to move the sewer line.
That's how close the building would be to the sewer line. The sewer line is that green line, the white kind of square.
I see. So you wouldn't have to move it?
Well, no, I wouldn't move it. It would be exposed. The sewer line, I really, that would be, I wouldn't even consider it.
It's quite a drop-off here, so we have to bring it down to where the driveway is.
This stone wall is about 3 feet.
Yep.
The height of that stone wall.
I think I got it.
And the sewer is maybe a foot and a half, 2 feet under that pavement, roughly.
And again, this is perhaps a question for you or for Ben, but are these little X's with 99.26, 99.2, are those the depth of the ledge? How deep is the ledge?
Where are you looking? On the...
Well, on your
on the plot plan?
Those usually just indicate spot elevations.
Elevations.
Of the ground. Not ledge.
How deep is the ledge that you're concerned about?
I have no way of knowing.
Until we start digging.
Until you start digging it. I mean, the ledge is roughly, I mean, I have pieces of rock that are showing on my lawn now as to whether or not that's the top of the ledge, so it could be, I mean, I have a rock that's probably, 10 feet off the middle of the side of the building there, so that could be a top of one of the pieces of ledge, or it could be just a big rock.
I see.
I know there is ledge, just when I was trying to do my dog pen that was down back there, when I dug that by hand, I was into ledge. So on towards the middle to the back property line of the proposed garage, it would only be less than a foot.
Okay. You said that you have a garage in the house currently?
There is, yes, underneath the house.
So the house has a basement?
The house does have a basement. It's a walkout daylight basement to the back. The front half, if you're looking at the house from the street, the left half of the front of the house is a full wall basement. The right half is a half daylight basement.
I guess if the house has a basement, you've never taken borings.
It's a den. Our den is in the basement.
I'm sorry?
Our den is in the basement, so it's like living space. It's not storage space.
I understand. The point is, your basement is dug down fairly deep, and there's no ledge.
Well, I can't say that there wasn't ledge when they built it. I'm sure that there was.
You're suggesting they blasted out ledge to put in the foundation for this ranch?
Well, if you see the topical, it's high in one corner and it drops way down low in the other. So the house is built kind of down in the low part. And
My neighbor had said, when we had talked to him about some of this, he had said that he'd had problems directly across the street when they were doing blasting to put the houses in after his house. He'd had a no water problem in his basement, but afterwards, the blasting to put some of these buildings, the houses in, he then had a water issue in his basement, so they came back and put an under drain.
Okay.
So there was blasting. I mean, it's just...
Okay. Well, I guess the issue is, I mean, as I understand it, your sort of sole issue is the expense of moving this 3-bay garage 5 feet because of the cost of ledge. But in fact, you don't have any borings in that, I mean, a simple boring or two in that, I mean, that was the original question. And I guess, in fact, you don't have any borings in that 5 feet space to have any idea whether that's a problem or not.
I'm pretty sure there is a problem. It's whether or not it's going to be 4 or 5 feet of ledge.
Okay, the new structure does not have a basement, correct?
No.
No, it'd be a slab.
Okay.
But you do have to have a frost wall, and you do have to have a retaining wall that would hold back that part of the banking.
Okay, let me go back to another issue that you actually raised. Your pictures of these other buildings, the other garages, we'll call them. I mean, I guess you've supplied them, but it seems to me they do show, in fact, that this one is quite out of character with the others. I mean, the fact is, all of those are two-bay garages, which has been pointed out would comfortably fit within the setback, except for two. Of the two that are larger, one is on a lot that's about 3 times as big as yours, and one is on a lot that's 5 times as big as yours. The comparable lots to yours are all two-bay garages. And again, just in terms of the character of the neighborhood, you know, this is a very large structure relative to the lot size and the size of the house. Now, again, if you moved at 5 feet, you could presumably get your permit and be done with us and wouldn't have to talk to us. But I think once you're in here, that to me raises that question. If my fellow board members will indulge me, maybe another 3 or 4 minutes. Again, is that a wall that's shown in the very back of the lot, the little circles? Is that a wall or a?
It's actually a rock wall.
Is it what?
The circles
are
on that back line. That's a rock wall.
That's a rock wall, like an old stone wall or a current constructed rock wall?
Nope. It goes almost the length of that development.
Okay. And again, just to understand, the in back of your property, according to this map, there's like a triangle.
Yes.
That is not owned by.
That's I brought that up to the tax assessor, and I actually even talked to Ben about it, and it's kind of one of those anomalies, I guess, that happens in the world. He kind of equated it to something about trying to put a square building on a round rubber ball. Well, things just happen. I don't know whose land it is.
Whose is it, Ben? Is it the city's then?
I don't know. I think it's an inconsistency on the tax map. I could.
Well, no, it appears from the measurement of lots that there is a triangle. I mean, if you look at lot 31 and 32, there's a difference in the back.
Right. It's not picked up on the survey.
All right.
And I'd have to go more in depth with the assessor to get to the bottom of that. I don't think it affects this situation, though.
Okay. In back of your property, there's a shed on your abutter.
Yes.
According to the size and shape of that triangle, that shed is well into that no man's land. Is that correct?
I would assume so, but I haven't. Okay. There's no property lines for him. Guessing, I guess.
In any case, it is only 3.9 feet from your property line. Is that correct?
Well, it's probably less than that. If you're talking the rock wall, where that rock wall is in relationship to these property lines, I couldn't tell you if it's on the line. I know my pins that the surveyor just put in are on my side of the rock wall.
Okay. Well, this, so, according to this survey, if that shed is located correctly.
Yeah, it would roughly, yeah, right. From my property line to his shed, that would be correct.
So that is, again, the corner of it, the closest corner is 3.9 feet from your property line. I mean, that's the way it is if you're out there.
Correct.
That it looks like.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I think my other questions are probably discussion questions.
Any other questions from the board? Okay. Thank you. Any public comment? Yes, sir.
I Hello, my name is John DeMarco. I live on Shevers Road, directly behind the Martins. I respectfully object to the zoning variance. The Martins are seeking to add a detached three-car garage to go along with the current garage. I believe they fail in providing both the practical difficulty and the significant economic injury. Excuse me. My kids were lucky enough to give me the cold that's been going around Cape. So, as for the significant economic injury, I believe there's only one property in the surrounding neighborhoods, both on and off Columbus Road, that have a four-car garage. Overwhelmingly, the houses have a two-car or less garage, so no significant economic injury. As for the practical difficulty, I believe there is none. The excavator, as well as any other equipment needed to make any perceived changes that are being complained as being far too difficult to overcome, will be on site. So in essence, it comes down to the application implies moving some depressed PVC piping that is not even fully buried, according to the pictures that were in the application. As for the sewer line, I did not see it on the application, so I couldn't tell, you know, where it was. I do know when I purchased my house, we had two sewer lines, and we both have a small house. I had two sewer lines, and when we did our renovation, I was asked to consolidate them and upgrade it to just one, and that's what we did, and it was not difficult. And I do understand about the ledge in Cape Elizabeth. As for the application, in Section B, the Martins state that the abutting neighbors will not lose any sight lines. Unfortunately, that is false. The elevation difference between the Martins' property and my property on Shevers Road is significant. I do not see how replacing a small shed with a two-story building can be thought of as having no loss of sight lines from either inside my house or sitting around my fire pit, which is located on the back quarter of my property. As for the supporting photos that went along with the application, if you look at the location of the houses mentioned in the photo references and the Martins' property, you will see the majority are outside the 10-house neighborhood guidelines. In fact, I would say that most are in adjoining neighborhoods. I believe two houses being on Mitchell Road. As for the seven photos, I believe five, perhaps all, are on conforming lots. As for Section D, the Martins regularly leave a commercial vehicle running outside overnight with their outside lights on as well in the wintertime. So I do have a question if any commercial vehicles will be stored there. That's only in the winter, usually if there's a storm. That's really kind of the essence of what I had to ask about the variance and some of the reasons why I'm against it.
Any questions?
That will significantly, obviously, hurt my property value because it will be right on top. We've got about 3 to 4 feet height difference between my land and their land, which slopes up. So adding such a big unit, fine, but moving it even closer, sorry, I just can't, you know, agree with that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Any questions? Thanks.
Any questions?
Seeing nobody else in the audience, there's no further public comment. So I'd like to open it up for board discussion.
I'm going to make an observation to start off. I have no problems with having 3, 4, 5 big garage. No problem. They have the space. However, as John mentioned, once you go over the setback requirements, there's other considerations that come into play. And I think there are fair points to be made that if other neighbors have only 1 and 2 bay garages, well, this is pushing the boundary a little further as to what is, it's almost a creep of expectations. So that's the first point. The second point is, I'm troubled with the practical difficulty here because we've had in the past other people coming in, other applicants, talking about they want a kitchen in front of their house and it's too close to the road, but they can put the kitchen elsewhere on the house and you can still have the kitchen. This is a convenience issue. I'm not persuaded at the moment. I can certainly change my mind if you can pitch it to me. That the reasons for having this structure where it is does not meet the test. And certainly, you can move it a little bit, slide it front to the property, remove the sewer line. There's other options to have here. I even looked at whether you can have an accessory building, but I guess it's limited to 8.5 feet for an accessory building. We had an application some time ago when a person sought to put an accessory building closer to the property line. I think it was 5 or 10 feet, whatever it was. But that option is not available here because it doesn't meet requirements for a garage. I'm troubled as to how we get past some of the requirements in the ordinance that's going to require us to focus on.
I agree. I mean, I don't think the application does. I don't think there's a significant economic injury. They can build a two-car garage within the setbacks. They might be able to build a three-car garage. They do some excavation, which we've heard isn't necessarily going to cost exorbitant amount of money. And I mean, the test for practical difficulty is strict application of the ordinance precludes the ability of the property owner to pursue a use permitted in the zoning district in which the property is located and result in significant economic injury. And then significant economic injury is placing the applicant for a variance at a disadvantage in the neighborhood by applying zoning ordinance standards, which would prevent the applicant from having a structure or accessory structure comparable in size, location, and number to those other lot owners in the immediate neighborhood, but in no case 10 of the nearest property owners. We don't have 10 that have even been submitted, we have 7. And there are a couple that are three-car garages or possibly 4 on one property, but there's also plenty of two-car garages that have been submitted, which they could construct within the setback, the required setback. And them building a two-car garage actually gives them three-car garage, three cars, the equivalent of a three-car garage, because they already have one within their house. So, I mean, unless I hear something from somebody, you know, that's very convincing to me, I don't think it meets the practical difficulty or the significant economic injury.
I agree, and I think it's a relatively clear case here, and Mr. and Mrs. Martin, you probably understand from submitting the application and going through the criteria that the board doesn't simply have free discretion to grant or deny these sorts of things. We apply state law, and where there are required setbacks at issue, it's a pretty high hurdle to be able to clear the requirements set forth both by the local ordinance and through adoption state law. So it makes our job difficult at times when dealing with applicants like yourselves who obviously simply want to improve the condition of your property, improve your living arrangements. But unfortunately, we're in a situation where the standards simply aren't met. I'm afraid that I too have to join with the chorus here and say that it seems as though it's appropriate and in keeping with both the local ordinance and state law that we deny the application.
I just want to add to one more point to that. Mr. DeMarco mentioned that it may tower over his property. I took that in, but if the structure is on the setback, it can still go up 35 feet or whatever the ordinance allows. So there's still it can still be a sizable structure that's within the property line if they so choose. So I take the point, there is space to build, and the question is, there's a cost benefit and a size benefit as well.
Agreed. There do seem to be some very reasonable alternatives here, which is part of the issue we face. And I'd be pleased to make a motion if and when the board would like to entertain that. I'd move that the Zoning Board of Appeals deny the request of Timothy and Catherine Martin
for a variance to build a 35 by 28 foot garage on the left rear corner of their non-conforming lot at 13 Thrasher Road.
I'll second that.
Any discussion on the pending motion? All in favor? So the motion to deny the request of Timothy and Catherine Martin for a variance to construct a 35 by 28 garage on their property at 13 Thrasher Road, map U32, lot 6-10, is denied. A couple findings of fact. Timothy and Catherine Martin are the owners of record of the property located at 13 Thrasher Road, map U32, lot 6-10. Two, the subject property is a non-conforming lot in the RC zone. Three, the zoning ordinance section 19-4-3A requires a rear setback of 15 feet. I think we can then just jump to the conclusion, which is there is a substantial departure from the intent of the ordinance, and a literal enforcement of the ordinance would not cause a practical difficulty as defined by 30 AMRSA section 4353-4C. All in favor of those findings of fact and the conclusion? 6-0. Thank you. Unless there's any other business, a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
You're adjourned.